New fuel coilovers.
Doubling the value of the car.
More than doubling the value of the car.
All right, values with actually worth, right? Not with a K.
Well, it's gonna make it nice though. Got some upgrades going on to this thing. Suspension upgrades. Look at that. Max Motorsports caster camber plates on top of those bad boys.
I'm realizing I didn't bring a drill bit just now.
Oh shoot. I think I got some drift spec coilovers here. 441s.
Gnarly front rates. Gnarly front rates.
Yeah, those are stiff, stiff springs. So yeah. Definitely a nice little setup there.
Make this look cute for the gram.
Excited to get these things on.
Yeah, I'm so excited.
Wow. Okay.
Showing the lows. Look at the rocker height versus.
Yeah.
Is she rad? That's definitely not.
That's not gonna fly.
Yeah.
All right. So you can see here, this is the stock. Huge stock McPherson strut setup, and here's the fuel setup. That's quite a bit of a weight savings, huh?
Yeah, little.
Damn, that's full droop. Yeah, well, that's all right. I mean, we can kind of get an idea for. We'll see it when she slammed down. Looks pretty fancy, bud. Looks pretty fancy. Wow.
So that's gonna be pretty low, yeah? Four inches up on the ground.
Looks so good.
What was our wheel gap before?
Not bad. The front's way up in the air.
Front end needs to come down.
We're not gonna look at that for now. We're focusing on the rear here.
Well, I want reverse rank. I want the fucking ass out of the car to sit down and like drag around.
Like real drift car shit.
Yeah, I want my front suspension to have the correct angle so that it's not like diving and compressing and changing my toe as the suspension compresses. Like, so if the arm's all fucked off at a super steep angle, it comes out and you have a bunch of toe in, right?
Yeah.
And if you have it like super upside down and it pushes in, then it'll toe out as the arm changes length. So the front control arms are, well, we moved it to 12 and like a half instead of 12 where I had it set. I think we're gonna go to like 11, which is like the height from the bottom of the spring to the bottom of the coil. Something that's measurable and consistent. So
lower the front down a little bit. And
yeah, I think the rear, I'm gonna go down a little bit in the rear too, like a quarter inch. Cause I want the rear end to be like dirt nasty low. Nasty low.
But we'll see.
It's gotta stay up. And then we gotta fix the exhaust. The exhaust is going to scrape, like it scraped before, and it was at a monster truck ride height. So.
All right.
I have to take the coilovers and everything back off. Okay.
Oh, shit. There. Yeah.
Physically contacting the body.
There's just no bushing in there. Mm-hmm. Just then, metal on metal.
And then this side. It's the same way.
Okay.
Same.
Great.
Yeah. And then the upper is hammered.
Okay.
Yeah. Right, this one's not great. Okay, let's go up. And so now we're going to look at the drive shaft really quick. Sean Alger just noted something. The drive shaft itself here comes from this end. The drive shaft is now hitting the floor over here.
That's amazing that it shifts so that far.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's wild.
So we need, and luckily we have all the parts coming for the rear arms, but I need an upper bushing as well by tomorrow.
Whoo! Damn. Yeah, buddy. What do you think? Rear is nice and low.
I think you could use another inch in the rear.
Another inch lower in the rear and two inches in the front?
I mean, I don't want to go that much lower in the front.
I'm
definitely going to do a bit more. For sure. I mean, probably an inch as well, to be honest. But I just wanted to make sure I had ground clearance. It looks like we've got more room to grow.
Yeah.
It's cool. There's still a lot of stuff to do.
Plenty to do, but...
I put my angle kit on. That'll lower the front end down just on its own.
Looks good.
All right, first run of the Mustang since we got the feels on it.
Get out.
It skates on a 265 pretty well. Like once it's out, once it steps out and it's got weight behind it, it moves pretty well.
I can't see you, but yeah. Yeah, totally.